So we've got a football update. I'm here with Olivia Marshall. Olivia, we're going to be talking about Brighton and Hove Albion. It looks like the season might start up again at some point in June. I know you joined the most recent press conference there, Zoom press conference, I should say. What did they say?
Well, they're taking inspiration from the return of the Bundesliga. They're very happy with how that was received. I think a lot of people were just really grateful to see football back on the screen. I know there was a bit of debate on social media in particular about whether there was an atmosphere there. Some people found it strange to see empty seats, players cheering to an empty crowd. But the majority of people, majority of football fans, should I say, were just happy to see the game back on our screen.
Yeah, it was interesting watching that, wasn't it? Because it was a bit disheartening in a way, because football's not football without a crowd. But in exceptional circumstances, I guess, some football's better than no football, you know, the full experience. But I have to accept without crowds for now. So what else did Paul Barber and Hope House have to say?
Well, they told us that there was no positive coronavirus tests with any of the Brighton players, which is, of course, a good sign. And they're saying that all the players are very happy to return with social distancing and safety measures in check. So no one like, for example, Watford's Troy Deeney, who doesn't want to come back, doesn't think it's safe. All the players are ready to return.
Yeah, with that safe distance. We've seen some shots of that, haven't we, as well, from other clubs. You know, training just with a group of other people or training alone. So that seems to be the way forward. And Brighton, they're back in training now as well, aren't they, with other Premier League clubs. So what do you think of the Bundesliga experience then? It's a league I've followed fairly closely in recent years. Do you think it worked?
Well, of course, it has fans across the world. So I think for football fans that have been missing out recently, it's a very welcomed return. Like I say, the atmosphere for some, they didn't really appreciate it on the screen. They thought it was a bit eerie, a bit echoey. But I think that for the majority, they were just grateful to have it back on the screen.
Yeah. Do you think we're going to see games on terrestrial television for free? It's not been decided yet, but the government seems to be pushing for some games to be shown free at least. I think that would probably be a good thing for the Premier League and for the broadcasters to promote their services, to promote the football clubs. What do you think?
Yeah, I think, of course, there's a debate around it, the financial aspect and everything like that. But I think it'll be something really good for everybody to get behind, like the FA Cup and the World Cups, of course, shown on universally on TV for everyone to watch. So I think it might build people's spirits up during this time.
Yeah. What about missing football in general? Have you been watching all of these replays? I mean, every weekend there seems to be a lot of replays, the Euros, you know, old FA Cup matches. I mean, have people been missing football, do you think? There seems to be a slow build-up of groundswell of opinion that it should be back on.
I think there's definitely a big pool that football fans can dip into. I mean, there's podcasts, like you say, there's been endless amounts on television, old replays. I recently watched the previous World Cup highlights. Obviously, that was quite a success for England until it wasn't. But I know a lot of people enjoyed reliving that summer because everyone was on such a high then.
Yeah, exactly. So I know we're going to be following the press conferences, you know, every week at Brighton Hove Albion. So it's looking like the momentum's building towards a start to the return to the season. Albeit behind closed doors, and probably lots of games in quick succession. Is that how we see it, the season ending there, do you think? Because there's 9 games left for the Albion. They'll be playing in fairly rapid succession over a few weeks.
I think the specifics are still to be decided. Yeah. There's various debate going on about how it will continue, but I think it definitely will come back in some form.
Yeah, and I've been speaking to Public Health England as well, haven't they? The Premier League and the government, they've all been speaking together. So thanks, we leave it there for now, Olivia, and we'll catch up soon. Thanks.